Hello and welcome to this first part of a video tutorial series on the RCT Graphics Helper. The RCT Graphics Helper is an add-on for the 3D software Blender, and it was made by Olivier Werfers, also known as Olivierifier. It is used to create game assets, mostly referred to as park objects, for OpenRCT2, which is the remake of the popular Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. With this plugin, you can render 3D models in Blender, and it creates a custom scenery object for OpenRCT2. So before we get started, my name is Joshua Jacobs, and I'm a graphics artist, part of the development team for OpenRCT2, and I create content in our Open Graphics branch for the project. If you want to know more about the project in general, feel free to check out the official website here, openrct2.io, and the OpenRCT2 Discord channel, link in the description. Now on how to install this wonderful plugin by Olivierifier. This is the GitHub page. I will link you that as well. You will find it here. This is the GitHub page for the plugin. And now the first step to install this is to actually get Blender, which is a 3D modeling software. This add-on will only work with Blender 2.79, which is quite the old version, but that has many reasons. One of them being that this old version has a output style that is close to the original Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. Now, for getting Blender 2.79, you will need to go to the download page of blender.org, and you need to click the previous version link, and now you need to click on download any Blender. Scroll down here to locate Blender 2.79, and then I will download the install version for Blender 2.79b. Let that finish. And now you can install that. Okay, once you have downloaded Blender, we can head up here to Olivierifier's plugin site. And under installing, you will find the latest release link. In this case, this is version 0.52. Download this RCT Graphics Helper zip. And now you're almost done. You need to open Blender. Head into the user preferences under add-ons. You need to install add-on from file, and under downloads, select RCT-graphics-helper.zip. There it is. Now select the checkbox and save your user settings to keep it selected. This plugin will not work right out of the box. You first need to install some additional software to get the dithering correct. Dithering is the conversion from a wide color spectrum to a very narrow one, which is used in OpenRCT2 and the original game. The software we'll be using for that is ImageMagick. You will need to install ImageMagick 7.0.8-6 or higher in the Q16 without HDRI version. Now on this page, you need to scroll way down to find the Windows binary releases, or click on this link to get there faster. From here, make sure to select the latest version of ImageMagick without HDRI and as a static version. Let that download. And install the software. Great! Now you are done installing ImageMagick. Now for the catch. You need to add ImageMagick to the system's path variable to let the plugin in Blender find the software. I'll show you how to do it. First, you need to locate ImageMagick on your computer. It will be on the program files ImageMagick 711Q16. Copy this file path. Now, right-click on this PC and go to Properties. Here, you need to locate Advanced System Settings. In this dialog, you will need to open Environment Variables. On the System Variables, scroll slightly down to find Path. Now you need to click on Edit and New. Down here, you will have the option to paste your formerly copied file path. Click OK and OK, and you're done. Now, to test your installation, first you need to save your Blender file. Once you are done, you can locate the RCT Tools tab on the left-hand side. If you don't see this, press T on your keyboard to open the tool panel. You can switch tabs by using your mouse wheel. Click on Initialize/Repair. This will prepare your file to render your custom objects. Now, to better visualize what's happening, open a File Explorer window with your saved Blender file. Now, click on Render to see if your setup is working. This should create an output folder that contains this sprites folder with four views of the Blender default cube. This is the first step to getting your 3D objects from Blender to a custom scenery object in RCT2. You could now, for example, use Tolsimir's new object creator to get those four sprites into one game object. This is the first and very simple way to get a good output from Blender. How to get the output directly from Blender to RCT we'll discuss in the next video. Feel free to like, share and subscribe if you like what I'm doing, and see you back in part 2 of this video series.